This better not fall. Okay, I'm wearing my Ann shirt for a Cobra Kai video. Like, that should say something. Okay. Hey guys, it's me, 1239 here, and I'm here to give you guys sort of like a review slash thoughts of Cobra Kai season 1 and 2. Now, this series, I only started watching a few weeks ago, and that's because when this show came out, I wasn't really like, you know, paying attention to it. I don't know why. I just didn't think it was gonna be that good. I remember hearing when they announced that the show was gonna happen. This was in 2017. Mind you, almost 2 years ago. I remember like talking about it with my dad, and I was like, hey, this show is gonna come out. I just mentioned it to him. And then last year, season 1 came out, and I didn't watch it until season 2 was, you know, gonna start to be released a few weeks ago. Then I saw it on YouTube. It was recommended to me. I started watching it. It was surprisingly good. You know, with reboots or like, you know, any show or movie affiliated with something from the past, especially something that's so treasured and nostalgic, like The Karate Kid, you're gonna get people who are gonna immediately judge it. And I was one of those people, I guess, because I didn't know how good it was gonna be. There's some shows and movies that don't really do a good job with nostalgia. But this show, in my opinion, did one of the best jobs I've ever seen when it comes to bringing back something and creating something new as well. I'm just gonna talk about my thoughts on season 1 and season 2, just kind of bring everything together and talk to you guys about what I think about everything. There's just so much going on with the show. There's so many characters. There's so much development, especially with Johnny and Miguel as well, and Robbie. Like, there's so much development with like each character, even if they're not like main characters. It's really intense and really crazy. By the way, if you guys don't want to get spoiled of the show, don't watch this, because I am going to talk about spoilers, obviously. When I first started watching season 1, I remember the first episode, the first scene, that's when I got hooked, because you kind of see Johnny on the floor after 34 years of not really accomplishing or really doing much with his life. Ever since the tournament, he kind of like went downhill, while it was a complete opposite for Daniel. So that's something that's so, I don't know, you never really think about what happens when a villain is defeated, but in a sense, Johnny has never truly been a villain. For some things that happen in The Karate Kid, he had his reasons. And you can even see, like, there's a video out there on YouTube that came out a while before the series came out that talks about Johnny not being the villain, and it's actually Daniel. But there's so many different perspectives and stories, and they all don't really go together because they're so different. I really like that this series really dives into Johnny as a character, sort of shows how he was raised, and kind of shows why he was seeking for a father figure, which turned out, unfortunately, to be someone like Reese. That moment when we see Johnny on the floor, that's when I was like, what? But you really see Johnny as this like human, this human character that's not just all bad, you know? And then when we see Daniel, unfortunately, Daniel is not really, you know, my favorite character. Like, in the Karate series, Daniel was like my favorite character, obviously, because he's a Karate Kid, and Mr. Miyagi as well. But in this series, you really do start to favor, at least in my opinion, and see more of Johnny's character, and you start to like him more. For me, he's definitely my favorite character, so yeah. Okay, so now I'm just gonna talk about the relationships between characters and how they develop throughout the shows and what I think about them, I guess. So the relationship between Johnny and Daniel, it's a very interesting one because obviously it's so nostalgic. Their feud, their very, very long feud of 35 years. And it's just, it's interesting to see how Johnny's sort of like the underdog now in comparison to Daniel, who is more of the achiever and the, you know, good guy. But throughout the show, you do see Daniel kind of turning into a bad guy when he tries to shut down Cobra Kai. You can tell he does want like the best for, you know, the kids, but at the same time, if you look at it from Johnny's perspective, you can see that Daniel is taking something away from Johnny. The only thing he really truly felt like was his, which is, you know, Cobra Kai. He was like the best student. It's interesting to see their development throughout the show. In season 2, it's so weird because in season 1, I think episode 9, they were kind of all good, right? I think it was episode 9, episode 8. But they were like all good, you know, they were hanging out at the bar, they were drinking, they were having fun, and they thought for once probably in their lives that they could actually get along. And they start even bonding over Allie because they both dated her. And then in season 2, they kind of do the same thing except without mentioning Allie. But they start bonding a bit and they start getting along until madness starts to happen at the end of those 2 seasons. And so it's interesting to see how no matter what, they're going to somehow somehow find something to fight about. I feel like at the end of season two, it wasn't as, I mean, it was a big deal for Sam, Daniel's daughter, to be in Johnny's apartment while she's, you know, hungover and stuff, but it's not Johnny's fault. Like, yes, maybe he should have called Daniel, but at the end of the day, he did take Sam into his home while she, you know, was hungover. Daniel should have understood more instead of jumping to conclusions. That's my opinion. Okay, so that's that. I think in season three, just to like kind of predict now, I think that Daniel and Johnny are going to somehow team up together, which is going to be really interesting. And they're going to fight against Kreese, who is now the sensei master of Cobra Kai, because he, you know, was the original owner. And now he's kind of taken it back from Johnny. So I think that might happen. That's going to be kind of cool to see them work together, you know? Now, Miguel and Tori versus Sam and Robbie. The drama, you know, the teen love, teen drama. I really did find it interesting because at the beginning, you already know Daniel and Johnny, but then you start to see that the kids are also developing as characters, right? Miguel, who I think is in a way kind of similar to Daniel, like in the beginning of the series, at the end of season one, he turns into this kind of this like cold-blooded human, right? When he didn't show mercy to Robbie, like he became something that Johnny didn't want him to become. But then at the end of season two, you see how much he learned from his mistakes and he actually showed mercy to Robbie, while the opposite happens with Robbie. He kind of goes from like the troubled bad guy to like a good guy, you know, decent. And then he goes back to lying and insecure. Ultimately, he does kick Miguel off of the banister and Miguel like almost dies basically. Yeah, so there's, you know, that whole tension between these four people. And ultimately, I think I do prefer for Miguel and Sam to be together. I think that's what they're going for. And then Tori, I love the way that Peyton List, like the actress who plays Tori, she's so good with like her kicking. She like really fights. I love that about her. But she's so like intense. I think I'm more of a Sam character if I had to choose. There's so much rage, you can tell by Tori. I think there was a theory that Tori might actually be related to Allie. You know, that's how she's gonna come in. That would be kind of problematic. Yeah, oh my god. Tori. She started the fight at the end of season two. So there's a lot of tension. I really hope that, I don't know, Sam ends up with Miguel. Now, Kreese versus Johnny is another battle. When I was watching season two with my dad, he did think that once Kreese was told to leave Cobra Kai that he actually was gonna leave. But I was like, I don't think so. Like, I think they're gonna bring him back at least for like the last episode and something's gonna happen. And turns out I was right. And so Kreese is now like the owner of Cobra Kai again. And so that's gonna be intense. And like I said, I think that Daniel and Johnny are going to go against Kreese and his really violent methods of teaching, and they're going to somehow combine Daniel's way of teaching versus Johnny's way of teaching and combine that to overthrow Kreese. So that's gonna be interesting. I really like the storyline with Kreese and Johnny, showing how Kreese was that father figure but was a very troubled father figure for Johnny. But in a way, he was using that to manipulate Johnny into letting him back in, and because Johnny does believe in second chances than he did. So I don't think this time it's gonna be like that. I think Johnny is finally going to open his eyes and see that Kreese is not who he wanted him to be or who he needed him to be. He definitely is not that guy. But it's also sad to see that Johnny, even though he was, you know, like, he had all this money, he was popular, he ended up not having this, you know, healthy relationship with someone the way that Daniel and Miyagi did when Miyagi was still alive. So now I'm gonna focus on the Cobra Kai members with Johnny, I guess. I really like that scene where, you know, they're just talking in the woods. They ride their motorcycles, they go into the bar and they, you know, have a brawl with people, and they're just kind of acting like teenagers. It's nostalgia, right? But it's also really cool to see that the actors that played them actually came back and they're a part of the show, and it actually does feel very organic, and it actually does feel like they're in that universe again with Karate Kid. So I really enjoyed that. But it was really tragic to see, I think it was Tommy, right? Tommy died, but then he was put in that body bag, which was kind of ironic. It was sad to see Tommy die, but I think in a way Johnny, he does have that storyline, which is good, with his past and bringing that into the show. It was great. Next couple, I guess, is Aisha and Sam. When the show first started, I didn't know how big of a role that these kids were gonna have besides Sam and Miguel, Robbie as well, but like the fact that Aisha and Sam are like completely different, you know, now compared to season one, where Sam was more like of the popular girl girl in school and now Aisha's more of the badass. It's really crazy, you know, like there's a completely different twist, and it's all about friendship and like what's friendship and how can you be friends with people that don't like you. Aisha has Cobra Kai and some of the Cobra Kai members don't like Sam because she's a member of Miyagi-Do, while in season one it was kind of the complete opposite where Aisha was more of the loser and Sam was with popular girls, and Aisha wanted to be included but she couldn't really be friends with Sam if her group was taunting her. It's like a whole flip, which is so cool. Hopefully we'll see more fixing patches. I don't know, like I hope that they actually are able to start getting along. If, you know, Johnny and Daniel have to team up, then that would be great. So Johnny and Miguel, as I said, they are my two favorite characters, Johnny being the first and Miguel being the second. Oh, I love them so much. Like, their relationship is so cute. Johnny's relationship with his mom as well is so cute. And the fact that Miguel's mom is from Ecuador, when we heard that, when my dad and I heard that, my family is from Ecuador. My dad was born there. And so when we heard that Miguel's mom is from Ecuador, we like lost it. We're like, what? We were shook. It's so cool to see it being mentioned finally in a show that I actually like watching. Yeah, the relationship between Johnny and Miguel, I feel like in a way Johnny is sort of teaching like a Daniel-like character, which is so crazy. He's, you know, the sensei now, but it's so cool. It's so cool. I love them so much, and you can really tell that Johnny really does feel for Miguel. Like, he really cares for him, especially when the whole, you know, incident happened at the end of season two. I really hope that Miguel is okay, because I would like really feel so sad if he like ends up dying or ends up not being able to do karate anymore. Aside from relationships, which I just talked about, there are so many gray areas in the show, like with Robbie. You know, as I said, he was the bad kid, turned good, and then kind of the bad kid again. And with Miguel, he was kind of the good kid, turned bad, turned good. There's so many of that. I guess with the exception of Kreese, there's no really defined villain in the show. There's no one that's completely bad. I mean, Kreese did kind of have a storyline, you know, where he was homeless, and so you kind of do feel bad for Kreese, and you kind of are like, oh, well, he's troubled too. He was in the war, and that's why he kind of acts the way he does, and he thinks the way he does. But with the other characters, you especially see that there's no black and white, so that's really cool. I really enjoy that about the show. You don't really see that often. Like in The Karate Kid, you kind of are led to always believe that Daniel was the good guy and Johnny wasn't, but then you start to think about it and you start to realize it's not always like that. I like how it invites you to question who is really the bad guy and who is just human, I guess. Yeah. So the last thing I guess I'm going to talk about, oh, did I talk about Allie? Okay, so another relationship I forgot to talk about is the one between Johnny and Allie. So the fact that Allie might be coming back in season three, you never know, because there was that ending with the friend request from Allie. I feel like they really are leading up to that. You know, it's obvious, but the relationship between Johnny and Allie, what if he actually still has feelings for her, but then he also likes Carmen? Something can happen with that. It's going to be complicated with her back. Oh my god, that's gonna be so intense. The last thing I'm going to talk about, I kind of already touched upon this in the beginning, which is the fact that I prefer Johnny over Daniel in this series, because I feel like Johnny does have more of a character. He's basically the central character in the story, but Daniel doesn't really have as much going on, I feel, in a way, because he is always relating and talking about Miyagi like 24/7, I feel. And while Johnny isn't really all about that, like he has his own stuff going on, you know, and he does have a lot of good lessons to teach, so I like that about Johnny. So yeah, I think that's all I really wanted to touch on today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you have watched Cobra Kai. You probably have if you're watching this, but I really enjoy this show. Like, I really am someone who is, like, I guess nostalgic for the 80s, I guess, or 90s as well, because everything, like, I really, really enjoy, like, Girl Meets World and With an E, like, everything kind of has to do with the 80s and 90s, and this is just another one of those things, you know? And let me know in the comments below your opinions of anything I just talked about, if you're a fan of the show. Hopefully we can talk. I would love to talk more about the show with people. I might talk more about Cobra Kai in the future, but I am obviously gonna stick to Anne with an E. I love you guys so much. Thank you guys for always watching. Knock on wood for Selma. Follow me on all my social media accounts. They should be appearing on the screen right now. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye.